out the binomial theorem, and this theorem here provides the formula for the expansion of binomials having the form of a plus b raised to n, where n is a natural number. And the formula for this a plus b raised to n can be right now, you see now, we have the first term is a to the n, then plus we have the second term which is now n, representing the exponent of your first term, then multiplied by a, then exponent now is decreased by 1, or then we have now multiplied by b, which is the second term all over 1 factorial, then plus n times n minus 1, then we have times a raised to n minus 2, again the exponent of the first term a is decreased by 1, while b here is now increased by 1, so this is now b squared all over 2 factorial. Then we have up to n, then n minus 1 times n minus 2, up to n minus r plus 1 all over r factorial, times a raised to n minus r, times b raised to r, up to the last term which is now b to the n. Okay? So this is the formula for the binomial theorem. As you can see, the first and the last term, we end up b to the n and then we start at a to the n. Okay? Then we have the powers of a in decreasing powers, while b has increasing powers. And the factorial here represents the number of coefficients or constant coefficient in the numerator. So as you can see, we have here 1 factorial, so we have here now 1 coefficient or numerical coefficient for the variable terms a and b. And then we have here 2 factorial representing now the number of terms or factors in the numerator as n and n minus 1, okay? So that is how we look at the pattern of this binomial theorem. So then, let us have this example. It's called the following 2a plus b squared raised to the fourth power. Okay, so to answer this, let us identify a. A is 2a, then b is b squared. Okay, and then the n is equal to 4. Then using now the formula that we have, and we expand now a 2a plus b squared raised to the fourth power, we have the first term being now a to the n, and a here is referring to 2a raised to n, which is 4, then followed by the second term, which is now written on the exponent of the first term, which is now 4, then we have 2a raised to n minus 1, and it's now cubed, then you have now your b, b is b squared all over 1 factorial, okay? Then the third term now will be, we have 4 as the numerical coefficients and b, okay? Then we have now 2a decreased by 1, so you have a squared. Then you have b squared, the second term decreased by 1, so it's now 2 all over 2 factorial, okay? Then the next term is now 4 times 3 times 2. Then we have now 2a then raised to 1, and then you have b squared raised to cube all over 3 factorial, okay? Then the last term now in our expanded form is now b raised to 2 raised to the fourth power. So as you can see, the first term in the original binomial is now a or 2a, the given. So we have the last term now is 0, okay? So that when we now simplify this, we have now 1 is 2 to the 4th, that is now 16, a to the 4th. Plus, what about this second term here? 2 cubed is 8 times 4, that is now 32, a cubed, b squared. All over 1 factorial means this is 1 times 1, right? So it's just simply 1, okay? What about the following term? We have 4 times t squared, then we have 2 squared, that is now 14. And pointing over 2 factorial, you can say that this is also 2 times 1. So pointing over 2 will now be 24, and this is now a squared b to the 4, okay? Then we have now the second and the last term, where we have now 4 times 3 times 2 is, we have this as 24, okay? But we have 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2. So we can cancel this now, 3 times 2, and this is in the numerator and denominator. So what we have here now is just simply now 4 times 2 is 8. Then we have now a b to the 6. Then the last one now is b to the 8, okay? So that is how we expand this binomial using the binomial theorem. Example now, we will now expand this binomial dx squared y cubed minus 2ab squared raised to the power. Okay, using the binomial theorem again, so where we have the first term is dx squared y cubed. So this is our first term, and then second term is negative 2ab squared. And n equals 5. Okay? So what we have here now, the x squared y cubed minus 2ab squared raised to the fifth power is equal now to, we have the first term now being raised to the fifth power, and the first term is the x squared y cubed. Okay, then second term now is plus 5 times the first term, 3x squared y cubed raised to the 4th power. Multiplied now by negative 2ab squared, okay? Then we have the third term, which is now 5 times 4, 10 times 3x squared y cubed raised to the 5th power. Then multiplied now by negative 2ab squared raised to the 2nd, okay? By the way, we have here factorial on the second term, likewise on the third term, okay? So that is 1 factorial and 2 factorial respectively, okay? Then we have now plus 5 times 4 times 3, then we have dx squared y cubed raised to 2. Then we have negative 2ab squared raised to 3 all over 3 factorial. Then we have here plus 5 times 4 times 3 times 2. Then we have 3x squared y cubed raised to the first power. Then we have negative 2ab squared raised to the 4th power all over 4 factorial. Then the last term now is plus negative 2ab squared raised to the 5th power. Okay, so this is the expanded form of the given binomial using the binomial theorem. So simplifying now the terms in the given binomial expansion, where we have now the first term is the bx squared y cubed raised to the 5th power. We can also now simplify this as negative, which is 2 and 40. Then what about the variables? So we have here now x to the 10th because this is 5 times 2 for exponent. And then y raised to 15 because we have 5 times 3 for y. Then we have the second term, which is now 5 times 3 raised to the 4th power times negative 2 all over 1 factorial, that is negative 10. What about the literal coefficient? So we have here x squared raised to 4, that is x to the 8. Then we have y cubed times, you have exponent, 3 times 4 is 12. Then we have here now ab squared, okay? Then we have the third term, which is the 2 factorial will cancel with 4 because this is 2 factorial and this is 2 times 1. So what is left is just simply then 2, then 5 times 2 is 10 times 27 times negative 4. We have this as 1080 x to the 6 y to the 9 and a squared to the 4. Then fourth term now is we have here 5 times 4 times 3, then you have 3 squared, then you have negative 2 raised all over 3 factorial, where we can have this now as simplifying this now, negative 870, then we have the inner coefficient as x to the 4, then y to the 6, then we have a cube n to the 6. Then we have the fifth term now, where we can now have, we can now cancel the 4 factorial with 42, and then we have now 5 times 3 is 15 times negative 16 that will give you, or I should say that is positive now, and that is like a positive 240 x squared y cube, a to the 4, and with the 8. Then the last term now is negative 2a times b, raised to 2 raised to 5, so it's like negative 32a squared, and that is b to the 10, okay? Or I'd say it's negative 32 times a raised to the 5th, then times b to the 10. So this is now the final answer for the expansion of 3x squared y cubed minus 2a b squared raised to the 5th power. Okay, let us have this now, class. Finding specific term of a binomial expansion where it is denoted as arc term, okay, the arc term. And the formula for finding the arc term or this specific term, we have here now, it is derived from the terms in the binomial theorem. So we have here now n times the quantity n minus 1 times n minus 2, then we have up to n minus r plus 2 all over r minus 1 factorial, then times a raised to n minus r plus 1 times b raised to r minus 1. So let's say this example, find the indicated term each given binomial. So where we have 2a plus b squared raised to the 4th power, and we're going to find the 4th term. Okay, so you don't need to expand plus this binomial to find the fourth term. So what you're going to do is this formula now. This is the R term, okay? So identify first the A from the given binomial, so that is 2A. What about B? B equals B squared, okay? What about the N? N equals 4, and then R is equal to 4. So when you find now the fourth term of this binomial, the fourth term now is equal to, use the formula that we have a while ago, but we will begin with the denominator part. So that is now r minus 1 factorial. So r here equals 4. So we have here now 4 minus 1, where we have this as 3 factorial. Okay? So this number here in the denominator will indicate the number of factors coming in. Number of factors will be in the numerator. And of course, since the r is given as 3, so we need only 3 factors, starting with n equals 4, then followed by 3, then followed by 2. Okay? So we need only 3 factors. What about for the a term? So we have 3 factors rather, so we have a raised to, what is your a? Is 2a and raised to n minus r plus 1. So we have n is 4 minus r is 4, so 4 minus 4 plus 1, so we have a 1 power. What about your b? Your b is b squared raised to r minus 1, so that is now 8. Then simplifying what we have here now, we have this as 8 factorial means this is 3 times 2. So we can now cancel the numerator part, then from up now with 4 times 2 is 8. 8, a, b, the 6, okay? So this is now the fourth term of this given binomial, 2a plus b squared is the fourth power, okay? So let us have this second example, where we have the binomial expansion as 3x squared y cubed minus 2ab squared raised to the 5th power. And we are to find out the third term of this given binomial. So in finding out the third term, let us identify the a. A here is 3x squared y cubed. What about your B? B is equal to negative 2A B squared. Then identify yung N. Identify the N now. That is 5. What about R? R equals 3, no? Which is the third term. And in finding out the third term, so we make this again of the formula, and that is finding the specific term of a binomial expansion. So we start with the denominator part. And since r equals 3, so we write now 3 minus 1 factorial, and determine now the difference, that is 2. And then we place the factorial. So with that, we can now define the number of factors in the numerator, and that is indicated by the denominator, which is 2. Okay, so we start with 5, then followed by 4. Okay, then what about now your a? Your a here now is 3x squared y cubed, then raised to, we have n minus r plus 1. So 5 minus 3 is 2 plus 1, that is 2. Okay, what about your b? B is like a negative 2a b squared raised to r minus 1, so that is now 3 minus 1 is 2. Okay? So when we have now, when we have this now, 5 times 4, that is 20, all over 2 factorial, that will give you 2 factorial is 2, so 20 all over 2 is 10. Then 3 cubed is 27, times 10 is 270, times negative 2 pi squared, that is now 4, so that is now 1080, and then x to the 6, y to the 9, then you have a squared and b to the 4, okay? So this is now the third term for the given expansion of 3x squared y cubed minus 280 squared raised to the 5th power. Okay, what about this problem here now? Find the term containing a squared in the binomial 2a plus b squared raised to the 4th power. Okay, so to find the term containing a squared in the given binomial 2a plus b squared raised to the 4th power, so let us identify again a equals 2a, and then b equals b squared, and then n equals 4. So what about the R now? So we can define the R by looking at the given. So find the term containing a squared. We know that the first term is in decreasing power and it begins with 4th power, right? So you look now at your finger and then you count now until you have the exponent 2 on your first term, okay? So we know that the first term is decreasing, so it starts with 2a raised to the 4th power, then followed by 2a raised to the 3rd power, and then we have 2a raised to the 2nd power. So therefore, r equals 3, okay? So r now will be equal to 2. And with that, we're going to find now the term containing a squared using the formula of the finding specific term, where we have the formula as r term is equal to n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 up to n minus r plus 2 all over r minus 1 factorial, then we have a raised to n minus r plus 1, then times b raised to r minus 1. So since we have identified the r, which is 3, so we can now say that this is the third term. But we need now a squared in the given binomial. And let us now define now. So r, we begin with the denominator part. So r is 3 minus 1 factorial. But we have here 2 factorial. So it means that we need 2 factors in the numerator starting with 4, then followed by 3. Okay? Then our a here is 2a. So times 2a raised to n. N is 4, then r is 3, so 4 minus 3 is 1, plus 1, that is now squared, okay? Then you have now your b is b squared raised to r minus 1, so that is also 3 minus 1, which is now 2. So let us then simplify. So the answer now is 24 a squared b to the 4. Okay, what about this example here? Find the term containing a to the 4th, b to the 8th expansion of 3x squared y cubed minus 2ab squared raised to the 5th power. Okay, so we have now the term containing a to the 4th b to the 8th. And a to the 4th b to the 8th would possibly now be the second term because we have the second term originally is ab squared. Okay? So what we're going to do is to find out the term having now a equals 3x squared y cubed and then b is negative 2ab squared. Okay? And n equals 5. So what about r now? We can define r by we have the term is a to the 4th b to the 8th. So we're going to define exponent of a and b from the initial exponent, which is ab squared. And the result is 4. Both are 4, right? So because we have a to the 4th divided by a to the 1, or the exponent 4 divided by 1 is 4. 8 divided by 2 is also 4. So meaning that the second term will assume the fourth power. And when will that, and when, and where is that third? Or where is that third now? Having fourth power for the second term. So since we know that the second term will increase, so it starts at b to the 0, then b to the 1, b to the 2, then b cubed, then b to the 4th. So therefore, r equals 5. Okay? And finding now the fifth term, actually this is now the fifth term. So we can now have the formula again of finding specific term. So in the denominator is r minus 1 factorial. So r is 5 minus 1 factorial and this is equal to 4 factorial. Okay? Then how many factors do we have here now in the numerator? There will be 4, okay? Starting with 5, then 4, then 3, then 2, okay? Then we have the first term, which is now 3x squared y cubed raised to n minus r. So 5 minus 5 is 0. Then that's 1, right? What about then your b? Your b here now will be negative 2ab squared raised to r minus 1. So that is now 4, okay? So we got, let us now simplify. So we know that 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, okay? And what is then 5 times 3, 15? What about negative 2 to the 4? That will be negative, or positive 16, okay? So 16 times 5 is 80 times 3, that is now 240 x squared y cubed, then we have a to the 4th and b to the 8th. So this is the term that contains a to the 4th, b to the 8th, which is actually the 5th term. So therefore the answer now is 240 x squared y cubed, a to the 4th, b to the 8th.